About 2 years ago, I stripped and polished this back wheel back to a mirror finish. Then it slowly started dulling down and corroding. Now, I could take this wheel off, prime it, paint it, and get it looking lovely and fresh again. But I actually want to try something different.
Introducing the RC36 rear wheel, found on the third generation VFR 750s from 1990 to 1993. If you're lucky, you still might find one in a breakers. And I think, looking at the state of my tyres, it's time we put it on. Wouldn't want to run into some of the gars around here, like poor lucky Luke.
I'd say you might be in a bit of butter there too, would you?
What's that now, the tyres?
Yeah.
No, they're grand, I was just back.
I should also mention the rear wheel came with a Bridgestone Battle Axe 021. I've heard mixed reviews about these tyres, so while it's on the rim, I'd figure I'd give them a test. I personally always run Michelin Pilot Road 4s because they're extremely grippy in the wet, which if you live somewhere like Ireland, it rains pretty much every week, so I can definitely recommend these. The front tyre is also nearly out, so I'm going to be pulling these both off soon. I'll probably replace both of them with Pilot Road 4s. Now, let's get this wheel off. So while I'm loosening off this rear wheel, some people are wondering if there's any weight savings with this wheel. For this, I got the most precise instrument available to me, these pink suitcase scales. Let's see if there's a difference. Looks like the RC36 wheel is coming in at 12.4 kg. And this is what I love about the VFR, simple and practical. I'm sure the high-rise exhaust saved me from having to remove the whole exhaust completely as well, so that's a big thumbs up for the Black Widow high-rise. If you want to see my video on that, check it out. And looks like the original RC46 wheel is 11.7 kg, so I'm technically making my bike slower. Awesome. Raising the bike slightly higher gives you a little bit more room to raise and tilt the rim over the disc. Just avoid scratching that paint. Again, just using a bar and socket to tighten the wheel down. The proper specs here is 80 foot-pounds or 108 newton meters. So I must advise people to use a torque wrench and don't be silly like me. So there she is. It's as simple as that. And I personally think it looks much better, especially because it's the standard part. The wheel looks right at home on the fifth gen. So what do you think? Will you be fitting an RC36 wheel to your VFR? Let me know down in the comments below.